you have found Rise with Chuck. In this video, we take a look at a couple of Crosleys.
Now, the first race at Sebring was an index of performance. And that means that the smaller your engine, the less laps you had to complete. Whereas some of the big cars had to complete 400, 450 laps, the little Crosley Hot Shot only had to complete a little under 300 laps and won the race. Again, very simple, very basic cars. The car has a 44 cubic inch, 26 and a half horsepower engine. It's an overhead cam four cylinder. They are just tremendous revving little engines. They rev very high. It's not uncommon for a base Crosley engine to turn 8,000 to 9,000 RPMs and hold together just fine. And with a little bit of work, the Crosley engine can be made to turn 12,000 to 13,000 RPMs. They are tremendous little engines. They're all but bulletproof. I just had this one rebuilt this past winter, and when the guy rebuilt it, he told me when he pulled the crank out, it was broken in five places, and I was still driving the car. So, I mean, they're just tremendous little cars. They're a lot of fun and really very inexpensive for a restoration project. If I can throw in a little commercial, the Crosley Automobile Club has a very active website, www.crosleyautoclub.com, and we have a nationwide membership of about 1,000 members, and we're always looking for more people to get involved in Crosleys. When you get inside, this is to reach out and snap your snaps again so that you can be perfectly weatherproof once you're inside. There's not one on the other side because they figure the driver can go around and snap that one shut. Being somewhat nimble. Again, very basic, very bare bones, not a lot of fanciness. No creature comforts, you'll notice. No trunk, storage area behind the seat, and that's it. They're a fun little car. I've been involved with Crosleys for 15 years now, and I've had fun just about every minute of the whole time. Great bunch of people, great little cars.
Thanks for talking to us, Dave.
Thank you.
Thank you.
But wait, there's more.
Well, this one is a Crosley Farm O-Road, right? The Crosley Automobile Company was based in Cincinnati, Ohio. They were in business from 1939 to 1952. Pal Crosley is probably more well known as an industrialist throughout the Cincinnati area. He also owned the Cincinnati Reds baseball team for quite a period of time. But it was his lifelong dream to build cars. And this particular model was one of the last models built by Crosley, the last new model introduced by Crosley in an attempt to save a company that was failing at the time. The Farm O-Road was made for the small farmer who needed a small tractor, but also didn't want to have to spend the money on both a tractor and a car. Basically, everything on this thing is optional. From here forward and from here up, this is all optional equipment. It has a hydraulic dump bed. It has a hydraulic draw bar. It has dual rear wheels like a tractor. It has high-low range rear end, power takeoff, full hydraulics, has a hydraulics or a speed control, sold with a whole line of optional farm equipment, all right, that were made specifically sized for this. So what the guy could do is work his farm during the day and then come home at night, take off the tractor wheels, put on single street wheels, and go to town. In fact, the motto of the Crosley Farmer Road is, it goes to town. The idea was, you work the farm during the day, go to town at night.
A four-cylinder Crosley engine created 26 and a half horsepower. With the two-speed heavy-duty rear axle, the vehicle had 6 forward speeds and 2 reverse.
Is there any problem to get inside?
No problem at all. They're not much on creature comfort, very bare bones.
Oh, I see a seat, I see a steering wheel. What more?
It's about all you got.
fuel gauge? What kind of gauges have we got? We got the full complement.
Fuel, ammeter, temperature gauge, and oil pressure. Quite simple.
The Farmer Road was built to compete with the Willys Jeep, but at a third of the cost.